Praise the Lord, brothers and sisters. I am your brother, Royal Priest. I am so fine and blessed. I am so glad to meet you all. I believe that you too all are blessed and fine in Christ. So today in this video, we are going to talk on a topic, is material blessings God's will or not? So some people say that poverty is God's will. Through poverty, God teaches many things. And they even say that, they quote the verse which says, the righteous will hardly enter into the kingdom of heaven. And they say that, When we are rich, our mind will be on the blessings, not on the God. So there are many views. So today we are going to see what does the Bible has to say about. Not what the people say, not the emotions say, but we are going to see what the Bible has to say about it. So before going to the video, subscribe to our channel, Light of Truth, and click on the bell icon that you will be notified of every video I post. I will be posting 4 videos a week, Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. So come on, let's go into the video. So first, so it's always good to start from the books of beginning. Whatever the topic it may be material blessings, it may be healing, righteousness, whatever the topic is, it's always good to start from the book of beginnings. It means we can see how the God created in originally. So we are going to see to the book of beginning, that is book of Genesis, chapter 1, verse 28. And this was the word. This is God's word for the human, first word for God to the human. He said, and God blessed them, and God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth and subdue and have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the fowl of the air and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. And God said, behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed which is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree in which is the fruit of a yielding seed, to it that he should be for meat, to every beast of the earth, and to every fowl of the air, and to everything that creepeth upon the earth, wherein there is a life, I have given every green herb for meat, and it was so. So here we see that the first word for humans from God was to be blessed, to be fruitful. It means he actually was talking about a place to shelter and food. If we read in the next chapter, chapter 2 verse 15, and the Lord took the man and put him in the garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it. It means he is giving a shelter. He is giving a shelter to live. He is giving a place to live. And Eden Garden is not a, it's not an ordinary garden. If you see in the Eden Garden in the real original language Hebrew, it literally means paradise. It means the heaven. Literally means heaven, paradise, or the garden of God. The Eden was very overflowing, full of blessings. And even God says that you can eat whatever the foods you can. It means he is also giving the fruits to it. When I say material blessings, it's not only about money, is also a material blessing, but the food blessing, the food, shelter, clothing, these are all also material blessings which we get from God. It in abundance, in the full supply. When I'm saying being blessed, it means full supply, not being billionaire, not being millionaire. It's not being like a very rich people. I'm saying by being blessed, I mean that we have full supply. We don't lack for nothing. We lack for nothing. We can even give for other. That's what I mean when I say blessing. So here we see that in the origin, when God created, he created man with the overall blessings. He blessed God with all material blessings too for his life, later life. So second, we will see that we called Abraham as our forefather. As a father, we say that we are the hero of Abraham. So, how was the Abraham? What was the material position of the Abraham? We see that we go to Genesis chapter 13, verse 2. Chapter 13, verse 2. Yeah, that verse says, Abraham was very rich in cattle, in silver, and in gold. It says that Abraham was very rich in cattle, in gold, and silver. It means he is talking about material blessings. Abraham was not only blessed spiritually, he was also blessed materially. Even when incident says that even the land could not bear his blessing. One more incident, even he was richer than king. In that time, king were the richest people, but Abraham was even more richer than the king. It means he was also materially, but he was not only spiritually blessed, He was also blessed materially. He was expecting material blessings. It means, as a son of Abraham, as a heir of Abraham, we too have that rights. We too have that covenant rights to claim that blessings. We should leave a material blessing. We should leave a blessed life. That's our lifestyle. It's not a way of life. That's our lifestyle. Second way we are going to see about Jesus. How did Jesus live? What about the material presence of Jesus when he was present on earth? So we go to that verse, Matthew 26, 11. Yeah. Matthew 26, verse 11. It's an incident where Mary comes and pours the ointment on the Jesus, and she begins to wipe it. So at that time, what happens? It was the word uttered by Jesus. When people say that this oil could have been given to poor, so what did Jesus reply? He said, "For ye have poor always with you, but me ye have not always." It means they are talking about money, material blessing. This would have been sell, and through that money, many poor should have been fed. But here, in that context, Jesus said that, "For ye have poor always with you, but ye have not always me." It means Jesus is separating himself from the poor people. It means Jesus is not poor. Jesus is not lacking financially in his earthly ministry. Even we see that Judas Iscariot, who betrayed Jesus, he was a cashier of the Jesus ministry. It means they were having a material blessing in a lot that they needed one man to manage it. It means they were getting funds, they were financially blessed so much that they needed to appoint a man to handle it. It means they were financially blessed, they were materially blessed. Jesus was not lacking any materially in his earthly ministry, because he himself said, "Therefore, ye have a poor with you, but me ye always have." It means he separated himself from poor people. He is not poor, he was financially blessed. So after this, one more incident, I will say one more story. In that, about the story of rich man and Lazarus, we will go to that one, Luke chapter 16, 19 to 31. In that, what happens, the main incident is, people say that the rich man went to hell, and the poor, the beggar one, went to Abraham also. Yeah, it's right, absolutely right. But people say that, many people say that the rich man went to hell because he was rich. But what the Bible says about? So we will read that. We go to the last ending part of it. I will read the verse from there. 16:27-29. The word says, "Then he said, I pray thee therefore, Father, that thou wouldest send him to my father's house, for I have five brethren, that he may testify unto them, lest they also come into the place of torment." So the rich man is saying, "I have five brethren in the earth. Go and inform them to inform them about this torment, that they will not come to here." So if the real reason of the rich man coming to hell was his richness, the Abraham would have said that, I will tell them to sell their every goods, every material blessings, then they can come to heaven. But Abraham didn't say that. Abraham said something very interestingly. He said, Abraham said unto him, "They have Moses and prophets, let them hear them." And he said, "Nay, Father Abraham, but if one went unto them from the dead, they will repent." He said unto him, "If they hear not Moses and the prophets, neither will they be persuaded through one rose from the dead." It means Abraham said, the reason for rich man to come to come to hell was not his richness, but it was his disobedience to law. He was not following the law and prophets. In Old Testament, the people have to follow law and have to be obedient to prophets. But this rich man was not obedient to the prophet and was not following the law. That was the only reason he went to hell. His richness was not the reason to he went to hell. Because if his richness must have been his reason to go to the hell, the Abraham would have said that his brothers should sell everything. But he didn't say that. He said, "Let them follow prophets and law." It's very simple thing that rich man came to hell just because he was disobedient to prophet and didn't follow the laws. Simple thing. so we don't have to think upon much. One more thing, there's an incident in which a young man comes to God, Jesus, and said, I follow every law. And then what's the brother Jesus says that, sell everything what you want. And it's a very big incident. I have to interpret it very broadly. So I will be making another video upon that. So I will skip that. I will go to the next one. We will see that in next video. So I will see. I will give you three scriptures about material blessings. Promise. Actually, it's not a promise. It's a reality. Because promise is something we hope for. But it's a promise. It's a reality. So I'm going to say that verses. First verse, Matthew 6:33. Okay. Matthew 6:33. I will read it for that. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you. Jesus said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Jesus said, all these things shall be added unto you. What all things? According to the context, Jesus was talking about, I will read the 13th verse, therefore take no thought saying, what shall we eat, what shall we drink, where shall we be clothed. It means, Jesus was talking about material blessing. In the context, that we read that in the context, He was talking about financial, He was talking about material blessings. In that time, Jesus said, but seek the kingdom of God and His righteousness, the all these things will be added unto you. It means He was talking, saying that if we seek the kingdom of God and righteousness, all material blessings will be added unto you. Or it shall be fully supplied to you. You will lack for nothing. Anything, even you can enter in this way, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all material blessings shall be added unto you. This is what the real meaning of this verse is. So I will give one more verse, that is Galatians 3:13. Yeah, Galatians 3:13. That verse, as you see it, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, for it is written, curse is everyone that hangeth on a tree. It means Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. What is curse of the law? Curse of the law includes three parts. If we read Deuteronomy 24, we'll find there the threefold curse. One is poverty, one is disease, and one is spiritual death. So I will be even making the whole video upon curse of the law. So I will be mentioning small thing. The curse of the law includes poverty. It means he is also written for poverty. We are not into poverty. Poverty was a part of the law, part of the curse of the law. But now we read on the curse of the law. So we don't need to be poverty. We don't need to be poor. We have to be financially blessed. We have to live a financially blessed life. So I will give one more verse. Philippians 4:19. I will go to that verse. Philippians 4:19. Yeah, this verse did that. But my God shall supply all your need according to His riches and glory by Christ Jesus. See, here in the context, Paul was talking about the offerings given by the church of Philippines. In those days, many churches were getting persecuted. So in that very tough time, the church of Philippines were blessing other churches by their foods, by money. Even in the, we read the context, we read one verse, 17th verse, not because I desire a good, but I desire fruit that may abound to you account, but I have all and abound. I am full, having received of Epaphroditus the things which were sent from you, an order of a sweet smell and a sacrifice written to which pleasing to God. Actually, the Philippine church was not only given to the other church, they were also given to the Paul for his food, for his traveling, for missionary purpose. It means Philippines were financially helping Paul. In that context, Paul says that my God shall supply all your needs according to His riches in glory by Christ. It means Paul was talking about material blessings. He says, my God shall supply all your material blessings according to His riches in glory by Christ Jesus. It means material blessing is not against word. It's biblical. It's not that way. We can't be blessed. It's not that we should live in poverty. I proved that from Bible. The Bible is not against material blessings. It's our right. It's a fundamental right to live a financially blessed life. If you got something to learn from this video, please like this video and let me know your views in the comment section. and share this video to your believers that they too may know the truth. And yeah, and subscribe to our channel, Light of Truth. I'll meet you next video. Until then, bye. Thank you. God bless you.